Let's give it a go. Good afternoon, good morning, around the world, wherever you might be watching. My name is Max Braun, and I am here for Stanley Engineered Fastening. Among me are a couple of colleagues actually in the background, but also there will be another speaker. I will be introducing him later. And hey, welcome to the FastCast webinar, Fastening Solutions for Body and Battery Castings. And to us, to not lose any more time, I'd say we dive right into it to get you a little bit of a snack. First thing first, here's the agenda, and on the bottom left-hand side you will see a name that's Jane van Gompel. This colleague of mine unfortunately didn't make it today, but I'm here to fill in and happy to guide you through it. We will do a brief introduction, and then we do have three main topics that we want to talk to you about today. This is commonly used materials, joining solutions for thick wall components, as well as plasma technology. And I'm pretty sure there is something on the slides that you have not seen before. So I'm pretty happy that we can bring you very fresh results from the lab. As we will move through the webinar, there will be polls. I invite you to take part in these polls. We will be sharing the results live with you. And hopefully there's one or the other insight among these polls. Let's give it a go. Who are we? For the ones that might not know us, we are part of Stanley Black & Decker. Again, we are here as Stanley Engineered Fastening. So part of the overall Stanley Black & Decker that you might know from tools like DeWalt or Craftsman or Facom, and many, many other tool brands that are out there. We are part of the so-called industrial business group. And then again, as said, the so-called Stanley Engineered Fastening. So we're all about fastening technology. One of the coolest thing, and I'm very proud of this one, if you think about car manufacturing and actually cars out on the road, 90% of all cars have at least one of our fasteners. So this could be a weld stud, as you see it on the top right corner. This is where we have a very long record, a very long track record. The so-called Tucker brand that you might have heard before. But we also are offering so-called SPRs, self-pierce rivet systems, as well as the fasteners. And let me say so much, we will be talking about SPR and stud welding today. There's also other things among our portfolio. You see the big word EcoSmart on top right. We do offer so-called EcoSmart rivets for the SPR systems that are very low on carbon footprint. But it's not just the system as a standalone, the fastener as a standalone. We always come as a complete package. So you basically get everything out of one hand, which is us. We help you on the fastener selection. We will help you put it into place on the application engineering, of course. We do have the equipment and we do have the service and spare parts right there with it. That's so much on the intro side. Let's check out what the actual fastening technologies are that we can be offering or that we are offering today. Let's start on the top left-hand side, the so-called stud welding systems, short SWS. Call it no-hole fastening, so there's no hole in the car body. Rather than we're actually placing a stud that's 100% gas and watertight, single side access, and great flexibility when it comes to, let's say, making last-minute changes. This is actually very, very good. Then we do have on the top right-hand side the so-called self-pierce riveting SPR. It's actually very well good for joining mixed materials. It can also be used for castings as well, just like we can on the SWS. We do have very low cycle times, and it's very, very helpful to join mixed materials and cover a great range of material combinations. You might have also heard, and we're now moving to the bottom left-hand side, of the so-called pop rivet or after rivets. This is also among our group of brands. Obviously, you will not have any curing or cooling time at these, but you will also get a benefit of a single-sided axis there. And as we now move to the bottom right-hand side, this is an all-new invention that we just developed in the recent years, the so-called tucker plasma joining, to really point you out with the main benefits: single-sided axis, no pre-hole, although we can go into a 2000 megapascals top sheet and then join a stack of components. That's it so much. We'll move to the agenda, and as promised, there will be polls during the webinar. And here comes the first one. There should now actually a window pop up on your screen. And hopefully this, thank you to the team in the background. So which components are most likely to be casted? And we'd be, very, very happy to get your reply. There's also replies come in. That's great. Thank you for that one. If you are part of maybe HR, anytime click on part of my role, it is also good. As we see, there's quite some votes coming in, 20 already. Thank you for that one. As we will be advancing the slides in a little bit, we obviously will be looking at some commonly used materials as promised. 28, 29, great. And I'm very happy to, in a second, but again, we'll be looking at the poll results, to hand the presentation over to my dear colleague, Dr. Christian Rice. He will be taking you to the main points. You will be seeing me and hearing me later. We can now actually show the end results. Thank you for participating. That's quite interesting. Thank you for that one. And now, finally, Christian, I'll turn it over to you.
Okay, thank you, Max. So I would like to welcome you all, and I'm very pleased to give you a brief overview of current trends and describe our activities in the field of stud welding and joining technology. And I will start with a trend towards more cast materials and thick-walled aluminum components, also including those made from extruded materials. And I would like to briefly mention the challenges. So please, back.
Sorry.
Okay. I want to mention the challenges that we have to be overcome with these materials. You will see a selection of cast materials that have already been investigated, and then I present some results regarding stud welding on such materials. And regarding my short presentation, I will conclude my presentation with a description of plasma-assisted self-pierce riveting technology, and I will show selected joining results. And here on this slide now, on the left side of the slide, you can see an illustration of the University of Aachen. And this image is part of a study that was supported by numerous industrial partners, for example, through technology talks and surveys. And Stanley Engineered Fastening was also allowed to make a contribution here. The graphic clearly describes the trend or the strategy from the conventional body-in-white concept to body-in-white structures with reduced number of single components. And this reduction is to be realized through the increased use of larger dimensioned cast aluminium components. And as you can see, this trend graphic even includes the vision of only two or even one-piece body shells. Okay, the question, where are we in terms of realizing this vision? On the right-hand side of the slide, you can see photos of such components. Most of them were taken last year at the Foundry exhibition in Düsseldorf, the Fair GIFA. And I firmly assume that many of you are also working on this topic. And we will all see in the future to what extent these concepts will find their way into serious production and how successful they will be in long term. But to be honest, but we have to deal with them and provide answers to the questions and challenges that these new components present to joining and fastening technology. And Max, now to the next slide. Okay, so what are the challenges for stud welding, but also for welding processes in general when it comes to processing and machining these new cast and extruded materials? So new alloys with increased copper content are to be used. Remaining release agents for demolding on the component can influence the suitability for welding. And the general surface conditions of the components, the roughness and contaminations must be taken also into account. The heat treatment conditions of the cast and extruded components are a major issue. And then the complex components often show strong local differences in thickness, whether intentional or fluctuating due to production. And there's a challenge of adapting welding parameters, but this is often already part of the solution response. Okay, Max, next slide. Before I show you some selected results of welding tests, I would like to give you an overview of cast aluminum alloys that have already been tested. The alloys differs in terms of the range from new alloys for very large cast structures, often containing a relevant proportion of copper as an alloy component. The casting materials investigated to date also differ in terms of the post-treatment conditions. And for example, we have analyzed heat-treated and non-heat-treated alloys and looked at different surface conditions and their influences. And as you can see here, I've not been able to present all the materials we have studied in combination with treatment conditions. But I'm sure that this graphic illustrates that we have built up extensive knowledge for the weldability of all these materials. Now the next slide. Okay. Now I would like to present some of the results of our extensive investigations into this topic. Along with the weldability analysis of weld studs on cast workpieces and extruded profiles, the influence of component wall thicknesses must be considered. You will see results of welding tests on materials with increasing wall thickness. Material thicknesses from 1.5 mm to 10 mm and beyond were investigated by us. The blue columns of the diagram describes the average welding strength achieved by the stud weld. The orange columns indicated the statistically calculated process capability values. And with increasing material thickness up to 2.5 millimeters, you can see an increase in the joint strength. And this is due to the increasing material thickness. The gray curve also shows the welding energy, the increased welding energy required to generate a stable joint. The thickness range between 2.5 and 2.8 millimeter represents a transitional area. And here the welding energy must be further adjusted via the relevant welding parameters. And then we have a welding engineer energy is approximately 1,400 joules. From 2.8 millimeter wall thickness up to 10 millimeter wall thickness, as shown here, no further adjustment of the welding parameters or welding energy is necessary to achieve the maximum joint strength. This is limited by the failure of the stud shaft under tensile stress. A failure of welding zone does not occur. Okay, the next slide. Okay, and you can start the videos, please. So you can see two videos in parallel of stud welding processes. And we are very pleased to support our customers with these necessary process parameter adjustments in order to achieve the best possible welding results. And I would like to illustrate the potential for improvement using this specific example, as you can see here on the slide, on the left side, on the right hand side. The left hand side describes a real initial situation at customer side. The initial situation was a welding process that statistically often had impermissible arc short circuits. The welding process was massively improved by adjusting the welding current level, the number of current pulses, the current time phases, and the lift height of the system, or at the end of the arc length. So, and quality reducing short circuits during the welding phase were eliminated. And you can see this from, or you have seen this from the pictures and movies on the right side. Okay, the next slide, please. And here, in addition, I show you the specific application data here for documentation purposes. The welding for both examples were carried out on a component with a wall thickness of between 3 and 5 millimeters. The welding was carried out in three different positions, first in vertical position, then in 45 degrees or under 45 degrees, and the third variant was welding in horizontal position. And based on the lower specification limit of 3 Newton meter torque, we achieved a process capability index of 4, and this is an excellent value. Okay, next slide. Max, you're on your mute. You're on mute.
That's a very good hint. Thank you for that one. Okay. And thank you for guiding us through the slide. So here I am again, as promised. Here comes the next poll. This time you have the chance to openly answer, and I hope this works out fine with the Zoom quiz box here. What fastening technologies do you consider using for your castings? So could be anything. Let us know what you're looking at. No matter if this is welding, soldering, of course, stud welding would be great to see. Well, I'm not quite sure. Maybe the team in the background can give me something like a thumbs up if this is really working. We got some 10 answers, it seems. Unfortunately, I'm not in a position to see. That's great. Okay, so we do have answers come in. That's great. And I hope this is also publishable in a second. Okay, we got some 16 answers before. I think we had like 30-ish. Maybe some are still typing. I'd say we give it a couple more seconds. And again, asking the team, the SCF team, can we now show all these results? Okay, show details. So bear with me for a second. I'm trying to figure out the stuff that works. Okay, we'll put this aside. I'll try to show it at the back end of the webinar. Let's go back to the actual webinar so you have something to check out. And with that, I'm actually now turning it back to Christian, who will be showing what we are currently working on when it comes to plasma technology. Christian, back to you.
Okay, so now we come to a new high-performance joining process that enables the joining of highly complex material combinations. And here too, cast materials, often in combination with ultra high strength steels, play a really important role. And what have we done? We have developed plasma assisted joining processes for this purpose. We already mentioned this technology in the introduction at the beginning of our webinar. And I would now like to introduce you to plasma assisted self-pierce riveting. So we combine our proven plasma technology with the equally proven SPR technology to create a high performance joining process. With the plasma, we achieve a short-term local thermal softening of the brittle or the ultra-high-strength materials and thus enable the joinability of these previously unjoinable material combinations. The plasma enables a very concentrated and easily controllable heat input. The dimensions of the plasma torch are small, and the technology can therefore be easily integrated into existing SPR systems. The safety requirements are low, and all possible materials and surfaces can be treated with plasma. As part of preliminary investigations, we have also examined other methods for local preheating and summarized the advantages and disadvantages. So, laser systems are characterized by high energy densities and relatively small installation space. But we see the cost for the system and the high safety requirements as disadvantages. The sensitivity of laser systems to contamination, smoke, and vapors, which occur during the thermal treatment of coated components and generally in the production environment, must also be viewed critically. Our plasma technology, which is based on robust fusion welding technology, is significantly less sensitive here. So induction technology requires only minimal safety measures and maintenance work. The disadvantages here are significantly longer process times, larger heat-affected zones, and the limited use on steel materials. Aluminum materials can only be treated inductively to a limited extent. Looking at the preheating methods as a whole, plasma technology is the most suitable method. So, and now the next slide, please. Okay. I will now show you various joining results that demonstrate the performance of our system and start with an extreme combination. So we are able to join UDI bore with 2000 megapascal hardness with non-heat treated cast aluminum. The material thickness for UDI bore is 1.55 millimeter and for the non-heat treated casting, 3 millimeter. You can see the good quality characteristics in terms of undercut and remaining base thickness, both greater than 0.3 millimeter. You can see from the pictures and images, there are no fragments or splinters of the UDI bore. Cracks in the aluminum on the die side were not observed. And very important, a conventional C rivet of hardness 4 is perfectly suitable for this connection. On the right-hand side, you can see the maximum joining force is only 55 kilonewtons and the punching impact is drastically reduced. And an important statement that is only briefly mentioned on this slide, but it is significant, is the statement that our plasma-supported SPR, self-pierce riveting, is also suitable for hybrid connections, so with the additional use of adhesive. Yeah? The concentrated heat input by the plasma with only a small heat-affected zone and a very short heat input time make this possible. And I would like to show you more results on the next slide, please. Okay, with this slide, I would just like to briefly point out the very low joining forces. The color-coded curves describe the force displacement profile of the respective joining processes. The corresponding micrographs of the respective joints are also outlined in color on the right-hand side of this slide. And such demanding material combinations can now be joined with joining forces of less than 50 kilonewton if they were even remotely joinable without our new technology. The typical punching impact, as you know it from joining processes with higher strength materials, is now only very slight. And this puts significantly less strain on the joining system and also drastically reduces noise emissions. Now we come to the next slide. Here are four other material applications that we can easily join with our plasma-supported self-piercing riveting system. We have always joined Usibor 2000 as a steel material with different material thickness. Here, 1.8 millimeter Usibor 2000 megapascal and 1.2 millimeter Usibor. We have combined this with aluminum on the die side with thicknesses of 2 and 3 millimeter. And again, conventional rivets with hardness 4 are perfectly suitable. As can also be seen from the previous micrograph, the soft flow behavior of the Usibor material is clearly visible. There are also no fragments of high strength material. Notch effects within the joining point are therefore avoided. The materials flow smoothly onto the rivet, and the rivet is not overloaded during the joining process and forms a good undercut. The punching slug also has soft contours and therefore has an additional advantage. The maximum joining forces are low and the punching impacts are drastically reduced. The joints shown here could not previously be produced with this level of quality or were generally impossible to produce. And then we come to the next slide. So that's my final slide. And I would like to show you evaluations of elementary joint samples and the quasi-static tensile tests under shear tensile load and head tensile load. The bar charts show high strength values with a low scatter. The images below show that the strength of the joints was always determined by the softer aluminum. There is never a failure of the element or the steel joining partner. And that was my final slide of my very short presentation, and I will now hand over back to Max.
Thank you, Christian. And we are already at the end of the webinar. I'll briefly talk about the summary, and then I can actually read some of the results from the second poll to you. Again, thank you for Christian. I think we will all agree that casting and extrusion provide cost benefits and advantages, but at the same time, there's some challenges and difficulties to be aware of, and I don't want to say maneuver around, but to actually tackle. SEF is here to support you, as you just saw Dr. Christian Rice. He's obviously part of our expert team. We are constantly working to tackle these new challenges with you, for you. So if you have something that you're working on that you're currently challenged by, feel free to see us. Feel free to contact your local SEF salesperson. Just reach out, and we're happy to dive into it with you. Now, as said, a real quick check on the poll results. So I'll just read it to you real quick. So we have some stud welding, SPR, we have laser welding, we do have riveting among it, we have light rivet nuts. Somebody actually gave us plasma joining, which I'm obviously happy to see. There's people looking for MIG welding, FDS as mentioned. What else do we have? MIG welding, that's it. There's also pop nuts, pop rivets. Adhesives, obviously, to mention. Yeah, that's basically the main answers that we got. Thank you for participating on this one. And this really brings us to the very last slide, which is thank you very much for joining. So this was Christian Rice, Jana, who is obviously unfortunately not here today, and this was me, Max. I hope you very much liked the FastCast one, to mention that one. At the back end of the webinar, there's a short poll again, very short question if you liked it or not, if it was useful for you. We'd obviously be happy to get your feedback on this one as well. And let me just say, we hope to welcome you soon again on the FastCast. Thank you, everyone.